tonight is very, it's an emotional night for me personally, too. The Rittmans have been exceptionally generous with me, with your wisdom, with your friendship, in so many ways. And this is just, the last time I was in this room, I had to wear a hard hat. I mean, to look at what happened here, this is just absolutely beautiful. And congratulations. It's funny, I don't know if you're gonna remember this. Justin and I had this great conversation back when I was writing The Lost Symbol. And we got talking about the universality of our individual spiritual experiences across cultures, across socioeconomic backgrounds, across faiths, that each one of us, as we look up at the heavens, or as we hold a newborn child, as we fall in love, as we fear our own mortality, these are universal experiences that we all have. And I remember asking you, I said, if all of our experiences are so universal, why are our religions so different? And I don't know if you remember what you said, but you told me our religions actually aren't all that different. That what happens with religion is that when we try to describe, using language, ethereal concepts like faith and God, we end up debating semantics and debating vocabulary, and that it really is language that becomes this a kind of barrier to universality. And what you have done here, by collecting language from across cultures under one roof, with enormous understanding and desire to unify, is an enormous service to humanity. And I'm not overstating. What you're doing here is incredibly important, and I'm very moved.
Mr. Rittman, much as I would love to congratulate you on your 60th anniversary of your remarkable, very remarkable book collection, I'm actually here for a different reason. It's my great pleasure to award you with the Frans Bannink Kok Penning of the City of Amsterdam.
Thank you.
Wow.
In this embassy of the free mind, we not only share wisdom, we have 25,000 books, thanks to the donation of my parents last year of the Bibliotheca Filosofica Hermetica. They're not all here, but we have the wisdom they contain at our fingertips. We have a selection of this wonderful library. We have embedded this collection, this core collection, in this house, but not only to study, but thanks to Dan Brown and Piers Bernard Cultuurfonds, the collection is also digitally available. So when you go online, and everyone all over the world goes online and click on the embassy of the freemind.com, there's now, as from today, 1,500 books digitally available. And they're so close that you can see and travel into the book, see the structure of the paper, see the letters on the other side of the paper, and just be amazed by how close wisdom can be. And what is so special about this library is that it shows and it brings closer a component of our European culture that we haven't known so close up for a long time. We have religion, we have philosophy. And there's a third component, and that's called gnosis, knowledge, wisdom. And that's about individual wisdom. It is not about institutionalized belief. So we believe that when acting by wisdom, we can, with all of us, and we invite you all to consider this, make a difference in this world. Well, in this embassy of the free mind, we invite you, without too much explanation, we challenge you to discover, encounter, and enterprise. Because with wisdom, you can see connection. When you understand, you connect. When you connect, you share. When you know, you act.
Thank you all for being here, and I guess I don't know if I declare this, but why don't you declare it?
Please,
no.
All right, I will declare the Embassy of the Free Mind open.